at random, an annulus, okay, and a node at random in this annulus. How many annulus do you have? You have log n annulus, okay, because the diameter is the size of the annulus are doubling each time, and you have at most n nodes. Okay, so you have log n annulus. So basically, if you ask the question, what are the chances that I get twice as close to the target? Okay, so you want to be, imagine that you are at distance r here, and you want to be at distance at most r over 2 from the target. So you ask the question whether your long-range link will fall inside this ball here. Okay, what happens is that you look at the exponentially growing balls here, and what's going on is here this ball will be contained in one of the annulus, because here it's exponentially growing, okay, and here it's half the distance. Okay, and so basically what's going on is that since this ball is about the same size as the annulus that it is contained into, okay, the ratio of these two is constant as well. So basically what's going on is that more or less you have a probability 1 over log n to fall into this ball. Okay, because of that. And the conclusion is that with probability, at each step with probability 1 over log n, you will divide the distance by 2. Okay, so it will take log n squared times to reach the target. Okay? Because it will take you log n step before dividing by 2, then log n step again before dividing again by 2, etc. And so it will be log n squared. Okay? So the idea is that it's fairly... we could look for this special long-range link that will divide the distance by 2 locally, instead of always moving forward. Okay? And that's exactly what we do. And if you explore locally what's going on, okay, then you can find a node here that will divide your distance by 2 here, and the depth at which you have to explore will increase with the distance, but at the beginning it's very, very small because you're very far away, so there are very few probabilities that you get away from the target. Okay, so you can really use here a lot of connections. That means that if you're far away from the target, you really have to ask your friends around you, because there is a huge improvement that you can hope from asking your friends. As soon as you're close, asking your friends will not be that useful, because you know you're close to the target, so your friends may only take you far away. And if you sum up all the size here of the exploration, you get that it's log n times log n. Okay. So it's almost optimal. So you have still this log n, and it would be nice to know whether its log n is unavoidable or not. Okay, so the question is that, you know, this algorithm looks much more realistic. You know, the probability that when you do search on the web, you will not follow the first link. That sounds reasonable. Okay, you will try and go back and forth for a while, and then you will decide that this page gets me closer, and then you will start again some back and forth, and then you will decide to go to this page. So this algorithm in some way does more sense. So now if you look at the question of, well, there is a grid, long-range links, what you have to compute all the distances, what's realistic in this model? Nothing. Nothing is realistic in this model. So... So, what's the question is, can we try to make this model real? Can we manage to make it real? And it turns out that it could be the case, in the sense that we can find an algorithm that I won't detail, okay, that will construct this model by using very, very, very little resources. That means that you will start from any graph, okay, you're in a graph, Okay, you will, we will start, but we don't know, we, everybody knows the geographic positions, the relative geographic positions, okay? And we want to build the long-range links, okay? You want to, you're in, I don't know, it's a planification of friendship, okay? You want to planify friendship, okay? And you want to do it in such a way that everybody is close to each other, okay? So, well, why not? So, I'm not claiming it's realistic, huh? Okay. The thing is that I will just say that the number of resources we consume to do that is realistic. So what we will end up is adding one friend to everybody. Okay? And it turns out that we can do it in very short time, log square n only, okay? With very small memory per node. So we just need log to the cube n. That means log square person. Everybody will know only log square person. And again, it's very realistic in comparison to the agenda of everyone and the size of the number of friends that everyone has and the size of the world. And by exchanges, only a few number of messages each time. Okay, you just send few, you just exchange some friend with people around you. Okay, and then you get a small world. Okay, so what does this result tells you? Is that I'm not claiming that Kleinberg's model, this justifies Kleinberg's model, but this tells you that you can construct Kleinberg's model in a realistic way. I mean, using a realistic number of resources in the, on Earth. Okay? So, the good news, clearly, is that you have a very efficient algorithm. Everything is logarithmic in the size of the network. Okay? So, it just say that, you know, Kleinberg's model might exist, okay, but it's clearly not a proof. So the course is that it's clearly a very artificial process, and nobody would do it, okay? But there are some very nice ones that exist, which are less efficient, but are a first step towards that direction. That's the move and forget algorithm. And the move and forget algorithm is the following, is that everybody, the idea is that you know someone, and this someone will follow some kind of random walk because of his life. Okay, during his life, he will just move around in the graph. Okay, but at some point, you may lose contact with him. Okay, so the idea is that you know some guy, okay, and he will just follow some kind of random walk. Okay, and at some point, you will lose contact. And you will lose contact with him at time t with probability 1 over t. Whatever the dimension of a grid underlying grid is, whatever the graph underlying is, okay, you will just lose contact with probability 1 over t at time t. Okay? And it turns out that this model, and when you lose contact, you restart from the beginning. You just find a new friend which is closer than you, closer to you, and again, this friend goes away and follows some kind of random walk. It turns out that this process converges to the Kleinberg distribution. Okay? So this is a much better argument telling that this would make sense. The only objection is that it's really slow. Because if you want to build a long-range link, you really need a lot of time, okay, to have it run. It would be a million of moves for your friend. So it's a lot to ask for a friend to move that number of times. Okay? So it's not really convincing, but it's more convincing in some way. Okay, so there are still a lot of work going on to try to understand how small world emerge. Okay, and there are also one question would be another validation of the Kleinberg approach would be to try to find the long-range links in real networks. What would long-range links be? Okay, and there is a lot of nice work in that direction by proposing algorithms that allows to extract long-range links from real networks, and these are based on clustering coefficient. And this works. I mean, theoretically at least. So there are theorems telling you that if your network has long-range links, it will find them. Okay.